It looks like a gain of nothing on that play.
Yeah.
Even though it's 42-14 and looks like Norman's about to score again, you guys have to remember it's still only the third quarter with about 10 seconds left in the quarter, and it looks like Norman's are going to let the clock run out.
And finish up the end of the third quarter with the score. Beverly has 42, Morningside 14.
And as I'm sure you probably just heard, that's the end of the third quarter. Norman's leading the Monarchs 42-14. So, you know, Trino, just to wrap up that last quarter of play, it's very unfortunate for Monarchs. Had a couple of opportunities. After two sets of 15-yard penalties and the ejection of the David Sadie, Monarchs fumbled the ball, giving it back to the Normans. And also on the previous kickoff return from the Monarchs, number 18 fumbles the ball, and it's picked up by number 5 in the end zone for another touchdown. And it just looks like nothing is going in favor of the Monarchs at this point. If you were the Monarchs coach, what would you do? Call it a game, put in the second stringers, or would you keep on pounding away?
It's late in the season. I'd maybe try and get my seniors to start, you know? To probably get them a good couple of minutes. It's going to be one of their last games, so even though it is a blowout, you got to get your seniors in. Let them have some fun, you know?
Giovanna Young. Please report to the announcer's booth for your concert tickets. Giovanna Young. Concert tickets. Announcer's booth.
Those are the Beverly Hills cheerleaders. Oh, wait, it's impressive. Number 3 there on the screen, Eric. Now, we don't have a name for him, but there's our mascot breaking it down. Looks like we've got something going on. Coach Carter and the referee is getting into a heated debate.
Giovanna Young is at the announcer's booth. Where are you, Justin Chuhead?
It's probably about the ejection of number 34, David Sadie. It's off screen right now, but you can see the whole Norman team huddling up on the sideline, surrounded by their center, Kaylin, trying to probably motivate. Let's see what the Normans decide to do here. Oh, the principal is now getting involved. Something interesting is definitely going on down in the field. Eric one's on the far side of the screen coming into the picture. Eric one's are matched up against a smaller defensive back by a long shot. Number 13 calling some play actions. And he hands it off to number 4, Kenny Bassett, who Kenny runs Bassett easily into the end zone.
Norman.
Touchdown, Normans! That'll be an extra 6 points. The score is now 48-14. Norman's leading the Monarchs. And now they'll be waiting for Eric Norman's. That'll be an extra 6 points. The score is now 48-14. Norman's leading the Monarchs. And now they'll be waiting for Eric Munzer to kick it through the uprights for this extra point. Remaining in the game. And it looks like Eric puts it right through the upright. Now this is quite the homecoming game for the Normans. 49-14. The beginning of the fourth quarter. Let's see how many more points the Normans can rack up. You know, prediction? Prediction time? Alright, I'm gonna have to say Normans 56. Monarchs.
I got 56-49 Monarchs. I can see it blowing.
Number six, after that embarrassing fumble on the last time, getting stopped at the 20-yard line. Another penalty on the play. You know, this is just getting out of hand. I don't see what could possibly be the... did you see any fouls, Trino? I didn't see any penalties down there. Personal foul against the Monarchs. That'll be half the distance of the goal, which will be at the 10-yard line. So it'll be first and 10 for the Monarchs on their own 10-yard line. So the Monarchs in a four wide receiver set. Number 11 still in the backfield. Number 7 taking the snap. Handing it off to number 11, who gets tackled by a group of black on last play.
Even late in the game, you can see why number 11 really racked up some yards this game. Normally when you think be out of gas, he's still showing his signs of brilliance right now, bringing it to the outside and picking up a couple yards.
Second down with six to go. Four wide receivers, one running back. And it's a fumble on the play.
Okay, we have one last set of tickets that needs to be picked up. Natali, come to the announcer's booth and see Justin Chu had to pick up your tickets for tonight.
That'll be third and five for the Monarchs. Let's see if they can convert for a first down. This will keep this game interesting. I hope they can do it. Another four wide receiver set. One running back. Number 7 under center. Dropping back. And it's a pickoff. Pick. Wow. Right to number 18, Marcus Zilberger. And is it to the house? And it is to the house. Oh, an interception back to the house. Number 18, Marcus Zilberger on the interception. Taking it back for six. It'll be 49-14. The Normans leading the Monarchs. This has just turned into a blowout, folks. Ladies and gentlemen, this game, I am calling it now, is over. I do not see any recovery for the Monarchs whatsoever. What do you think, Trino? Can you see any possible recovery after these past embarrassing drives?
I don't think it's a issue of recovering right now. I think it's just an issue of getting out there and participating at this point. Like, you just got to get out there and finish out this game.
Although I am a Norman, you know, I gotta say, I'm kind of pulling for these Monarchs at this point. I really want them to stay in this game, you know, so I don't want to get two down. I want to see an interesting game here. You know, we don't come here for blowouts. We like to see good games all the way to the end. So maybe the Monarch can pull through on this last, on this next drive and come through for 7 points. Andy pacing on the screen.
Varsity football coach, varsity baseball coach. Shout out to Anzi.
As you can see, you know, packed stadium here at Nickel Field on this Friday night, homecoming 2008. Let's see how number 7 does with this kickoff. Number 7 really would. And a great kick to number 1. The 3-yard line, he's running to the outside. Who gets wrapped up behind the 20-yard line, around the 10-yard line, in fact. Good tackle by number 31, Daniel Weisfield. Otherwise known as Texas here at Beverly. Coming from the city of Houston last week. Uh-oh. Is there a drum off down there, Trino? Oh, thank you, Trino, for reminding me. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a new leader of the free world. President-elect Barack Obama.
Hey-o.
You know, the president was elected on Tuesday by a landslide margin. Some 300 something electoral votes to a you know, John McCain didn't put up a good fight, but I guess there was no match for Barack Obama in this election. Guess it's time for change up in Washington, D.C. All right, the Monarchs. Not number 11.
Nice job. Okay, last chance for the college. Make sure you don't want to miss out on the pack. They're huge. How many announcers do?
Again, Norman Nation really pumped up for the pack. Pack came here for homecoming night. Gonna perform. It's the first time I think we've had a performance on homecoming night. Really excited about that.
Are you going, Jake, to the concert?
Am I going to the concert? Yeah, definitely. This is going to be an exciting Beverly event. You know, this is one for the history books. Such a popular rap group like the Pack in Douglas High School is definitely going to draw a huge crowd. And it's a handoff up in center, number 32. Gain of a couple on that play. All right, seems like the Normans are starting to take out all their starters. Number 19, Greg Townsend, coming in the bottom of your screen as a D lineman. And number 11 breaks to the outside, trying to run for a big gain. If it gets stopped around the line of scrimmage, no gain on that play. That'll be 3rd and 4 to go for the Monarchs. Ball on the 29-yard line. 8:15 remaining in the game. Two wide receiver set, number 4 on the bottom of your screen. And it's a handoff to the fullback, who gets tripped up and brought down. Gain of 2 on that play. So insane drumming coming down from the sideline.
Not bad.
Oh, excuse us. This will be a first down for the Monarchs. First and 10 to go on the Beverly 33-yard line. And number 7 drops back. Doesn't see the pressure coming. Escapes the tackle. Brought down for a gain of 1. And it'll be second down with 8 to go for the Morningside Monarchs. Call on the 35-yard line. And this is a 3 wide receiver set on the near side of the field outside of your picture. One man in the backfield, and it's a screen pass, number 3, who breaks a couple of tackles. Uh-oh. Drum battle coming right down the track. Let's see what happens. Uh-oh. Where is Nick Cannon when you need him? This is the formal clash of the Beverly Hills Normans and the Morningside. Uh-oh. Oh! Yeah, boy! Coach Mitchell not knowing what to call. Number 11 brought down for a gain of 1. Got some crazy drumming going on down on the track. Definitely the main attraction. Uh-oh. This just turned into a battle. No joke, this is gonna be crazy. If we could only get a shot of it.
Wow, great showing for this Monarch drum line.
No booing, no booing. Nice job.
Let's see what the Normans have.
It seems like no one in the stand is paying attention to the game anymore and just focus on the drum battle going down on the field. So major turmoil. Wow, quite impressive. Second and 6 for the Monarchs. Don't mean to get off track from the game, but second and 6 for the Monarchs on the Beverly 31-yard line. Number 11's running into the end zone for a touchdown. Touchdown, Morningside.
20-56 now. I'm not sure if the Morningside fans know it, but they're still down by 36 points with 5 minutes remaining in the game. You know, just the enthusiasm coming from the Morningside sideline is actually kind of uplifting. Now, I'd just like to apologize to the fans for not getting a shot of this drum battle going on down on the sideline. But in fact, the score is 56-20 as of now. Insane drum battle going on. And the kick is good. That'll be 56-21. Norman's leading by 35. Are we going to have a cheer battle too, Trino?
I don't know. Do you want to go down there? All right, so let me give you a recap. It's 4:32 left in the fourth quarter. Norman's 56, Monarchs 21. Still a blowout. But things off the field have been kind of getting exciting here. As you see on the screen, there's Coach Vonzie Basinger. Onside kickoff recovered by the Normans. Really close. Great onside kickoff, though.
You know what I do? First down, Trino, take a knee. Let the clock start running. Second down, just run the ball. Keep the clock in motion. Get a first down. Take a knee again. Just keep this clock going. Wow, this Morningside drum line is quite impressive. John Davides just checked into the game. Homecoming Prince. And there's a fumble on the play, the first play of the drive. Let's see what the call is. And the Monarchs recover. Can my prediction probably come true, Trino? Keep them to a field goal here?
Maybe my prediction could come true, Jake.
I can tell you that next week, Beverly Hills Norman's varsity football team will travel to Culver City. 7 o'clock showdown at Culver City High School. And today, before the game, Culver City had one loss.
You know, Trino, before I forget to mention, this is going to be our last broadcast next for KBEV.
Jake, is it really?
Graduating this year.
Yeah, we've had some great memories over the past 2 years that we've been broadcasting, huh?
Definitely. And it's a pump fake, number 7 decides to go deep. And then, oh, number 9 misses the interception.
Morningside drumline seems to have come through into the Beverly side of the stands.
All right, kids, 4 tickets remain. The last 4 tickets remain for tonight's concert. Calvin Berman has them right outside this announcer's booth. The last 4. You don't buy them, I will.
And it's a pitch. Number 11 who gets dragged in the back. Dragged down in the backfield, excuse me.
I'm not really gonna buy it, though. last four tickets, right?
4 minutes, 5 seconds remaining in this game. Trino, you gonna go down there and buy those tickets just for the hell of it?
Dude, I got you.
You could flip them, Trino, make some profit.
I feel you.
Supply and demand, simple economics.
Simple street economics. Alright, let's see here. Monarchs in a...
two wide receiver set. Two running backs. Number 7 dropping back. Number 11 going to the back, going on a flare. But number 7 gets sacked by number 16, Andrew Park. Ah! Saf on the tackle with the sack. Oh, man. Wow, number 16, Andrew Park. Longtime friend getting in for the sack. Morningside, strong eye. Fullback running back, dropping back. Number 7 looks right. Passes to number 5. Number 5 gets dragged down.
With a couple completions here, you wonder why the Monarchs didn't start out the game throwing the ball. I mean, yeah, they have a very talented running back, but the quarterback can make some completions, and if they just mixed in a couple of runs and a couple of passes, they'd see probably more than 21 points on the board, but a little too late now, turning the ball over to the Normans.
You know, Trino, all good things come to an end. Yeah. Depending on the seeding for Beverly Hills and the CIF, all depends on whether you'll see us ever again. If we get home field advantage, we'll be back in a couple of weeks, but if not, this will be the last time you hear from us. In the future, next year, you will have Ben Haver taking over. Excellent, excellent announcer. Future prospect for the NFL. Ben Haver will be with you. And it's a handoff to number 25, who cuts up field for a gain of about 8. Abe Kim. And that will be 3rd and 3. You know, I gotta say, Norman Nation, today's just been a brilliant performance by the Normans. Wouldn't you say, Trina?
What? Yeah. You want to say hi to your mom, Jake?
Hi, Mom.
Sure. All right, let's go back to the game now.
Strong eye formation from the Normans. John DeVitti handing it off to number 25, Abe Kim. And that'll be good for a first down. Well, at least looks like it from up here.
That'll be a first down for the Normans.
And that'll be first down and the game.
We're not really confirmed. If they have, they have one loss, and next week will be for first place. So coming out to Culver City High School, 7 o'clock next Friday, will support the varsity football team.
If what we hear is true, Culver City has, in fact, won tonight. So the Normans will be traveling to Culver City to battle it out for first place. Uh, 30 seconds remaining. The final score of the game will be 56-21. Beverly Hills Normans over the Morningside Monarchs. You know, this has just been a great performance by the Normans and a valiant effort by the Monarchs. You can see some action going on the field. 12 seconds remaining. Bunker. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, And that's the game. The Normans win 56-21 over the Monarchs. And this was the homecoming game for 2008.
Yeah, it's good to see the Normans come out really explosive for that homecoming game. Giving the fans something to watch, and it's really nice to see them blow out the Morningside Monarchs.
So, Norma Nation, you know, this will be our last broadcast in the future. Ben Haber will be with you to comment on the games from the future for all of next year. We wish him the best of luck. Too many hops. Bye, Norma Nation. It was nice while it lasted. City has, in fact, won tonight. So the Normans will be traveling to Clover City to battle it out for first place. Uh, 30 seconds remaining. The final score of the game will be 56-21. Beverly Hills Normans over the Morningside Monarchs. You know, this has just been a great performance by the Normans and a valiant effort by the Monarchs. You can see some action going on the field. 12 seconds remaining. Thank you. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and that's the game. The Normans win 56-21 over the Monarchs. And this was the homecoming game for 2008.
Yeah, it's good to see the Normans come out really explosive for that homecoming game. Give the fans something to watch, and it's really nice to see them blow out the Morningside Monarchs.
So, Norma Nation, you know, this will be our last broadcast in the future. Ben Haber will be with you to comment on the games from the future for all of next year. We wish him the best of luck. Too many hops. Bye, Norma Nation. It was nice while it lasted.